guys that can, wherever he fights, right now he's at the level where it's going to be a sold out arena.
What makes him unique about Triple G, he's a lot like Shane Mosley, where nobody has anything bad to say about him. It's hard to find, every fighter has, you know, haters and people that, but he doesn't have haters. There's nothing bad. But Tom, let me ask you this. You promoted the heavyweights for many years, the Klitschkos. You guided them.
We did at K2 Promotions. We did the most heavyweight championship bouts of this century. So, you know, we're proud of all the work we did with Vitaly and with Vladimir Klitschko. They're guys that just dominated the market. You know, I haven't seen guys that would sell out soccer stadiums. I mean, right now Anthony Joshua is selling out one stadium, but the Klitschkos sold them out on a regular basis.
Fighting anybody.
In different cities, you know, in Germany, in Moscow. Vitaly opened the soccer stadium in Poland, in Wroclaw, in Poland, and Vladimir, you know, sold out the Wembley Stadium against Joshua. So, you know, those guys had such a great run. Vitaly Klitschko, you know, a lot of fighters complain about ring rust. I haven't fought for a year. Vitaly was out of the ring for 4 years, comes back, goes straight back, gets his WBC title back against the champion at the time, against Sam Peter, in a very dominant performance. And that's a guy, you know, I got a lot of respect for. What both those guys have accomplished. Vitaly's now the mayor of Kiev. Vladimir just came out with a new book, so those guys had a tremendous run in the heavyweight division.
So two questions. Can you break down Povetkin Joshua, who you know Povetkin, you guys faced him, and also at the same token break down Tyson Fury, Wilder, they're going to fight here in
You know,
December.
Fury, you know, Fury's a funny guy. That guy is a marketing machine. That guy gets headlines, whether he's controversial or what. He was the first guy to beat Vladimir after such a long run. Yep. I think Vladimir had the second longest run as a champion behind the great Joe Louis. So, you know, for Tyson Fury to go to Germany and take the titles from Vladimir Klitschko, that was a huge accomplishment. So I think Tyson Fury with his strength. And here we got Marco Deckman's army right here. Marco Deckman making his pro debut. Deckmaker's army, trained by Freddie Roach at the Wild Card Gym. Very popular fighter, Marco Deckman. So, you know, Tyson Fury did what nobody could do before, and I think that's a great matchup. Fury Wilder is a tremendous matchup, and Alexander Povetkin, what can you say? A gold medalist. His only loss was to Vladimir Klitschko in Moscow. I think that's going to be a good test for Joshua. You know, Povetkin seems to be a different fighter now than when Vladimir fought him, but you can never count him out, and that's the type of thing I think you'll see him motivated to win the heavyweight championship. He waited so long, but you know, I think they're both fights, both great fights, and you know, we'll see if the champions at some point, you know, can work out a deal to fight each other.
Does Tyson Fury have a chance against Wilder? Because Wilder hits so hard, Fury likes to bump.
I think Tyson Fury has a great chance against Wilder. I have a lot of respect for Deontay Wilder in terms of his big right hand, but he came to the training camp. He sparred with Vladimir. I think it was actually two training camps where Emmanuel Stewart brought him in. Big puncher. But Tyson Fury, I think, gives anyone problems, you know, with the way he moves in the ring for such a big guy, his hand speed, his jab. I think he gives anyone problems. And you know, you got the big puncher with Wilder against the guy with Fury, who's got that confidence of beating Vladimir. I think Fury has to kind of get back in his you know, peak fighting shape. But if he's in his prime, you know, I think he gives anyone fits.